Hello students, today we will learn how to solve a complicated resistance circuit. To find the equivalent resistance between A and B, this is the circuit, and this circuit I am going to solve by three different methods. One is my favorite, that is CPM, common potential method. One I will use DST, delta star transformation method, and third we will use balanced Wheatstone bridge. So firstly I'm going to do by CPM, common potential method. So for common potential method, if you don't have idea about the common potential method, then in our previous videos we have shown how to apply common potential method in the cube resistance problems. Cube resistance, the most popular problems based on NEET and JEE mains examination. You can go to those videos and you can clearly understand how to apply CPM, common potential method. So here simply we are going to do A, B. Two points are there. These are A, this is B and A. So one point we will assume as positive, second point we will assume as negative. Either A to B we will be sending the current, or B to A we will be sending the current. So A positive, B negative, current will go like this and it will come like this. Now CPM, common potential method, other than A and B, we have to point all the points. We have to name all the points. This is C, E, already they have given. Any other point, this is the point. We don't require to give the name of this point because no resistor is here connected. Similarly for A also, in this section no resistance connected, means this point are the same point, this point are the same point. We say point B means we are talking about this point, A we are talking about this point. This we can say because no resistor connected in between here and here. Now for CPM, other than this A and B, C is and E. C resistance is there, E in between resistances are there. So C and E we will check, are they at common potential or not? C and E. So very simple, from point C we will go in terms of resistance to the positive terminal, then from C we will go to the negative terminal as per the resistance. C, how many resistance, the shortest path we will choose, shortest path we will choose to reach at point A, positive potential, high potential, and to negative potential also, that is B. So how many resistances are there? C to A, this is A, only this path we will choose, only one single resistance is there, R, value is R, and C to negative point if we will go, then this is only one single R. If you will go like this, this would be lengthy way you will not choose, the smallest shortest way you will choose. And similarly E also, point E is here, E to A, in terms of resistance only one resistance, and yes we have reached up to point A. So numerator as per positive terminal, and then negative E to B, one resistor this is, and value is R. So yes, both are one, C and E are at the common potential. One, you have decided that yes, C and E are at the common potential, so you will simplify this circuit as per CPM. That would be now looking like this. Hoping orally you will be solving, you can solve now. A and B you will put like this at some gap, and then C and E are at common potential. So anywhere other than A and B you can show this is point C and E. Now start connecting the circuit. A to, how many resistors are connected? A to C, A to E, any other? No, A to C and A to E. So we will connect like this, A to C, A to E, A to C this gone, A to E this is also gone. One you have used, then you start cancelling so that you remember yes which side you have used already. C to E also connected, C to E, now this would be 0 because C and E are at the same potential, so this branch would be neglected. Now B, point B to C, B to E, B to C, B to E, that's it. C, B to C, B to E. This is also used. This is neglected. Now this is our equivalent circuit. So now this is R, this is R, this is R, this is R. Parallel combination of two R, it would be, I'm just showing you. Now it would be looking like this, A, B, and this is point. Either you may C, either you may E. R and R parallel combination, it would be R by 2, it would be R by 2. Now both are in series combination. So equivalent required resistance in between A and B would be half R plus half R becomes R. This is your answer. This is my favorite CPM, common potential method. Quickly we can solve. Now see the delta star method. Same question, if we will do by delta star transformation, then what will happen? If you don't have any idea how to apply delta star transformation, then you can go, you can visit our channel. Now I'm telling you how to apply delta star. Suppose a very simple example I'm giving you. This is point P, this is point Q. This is R, this is R, this is R. If simply I will ask you, find the equivalent potential in between P and Q, then you will be very happy. You will see, yes, these two are in series combination. Then they will give you 2R, and then that 2R and this R will be in parallel, and your answer would be 2R into R divided by 2R plus R. So it would be 2R into R divided by 3R, RR gets cancelled, your answer would be 2R by 3. This is simple delta, you can see, triangle, delta means triangle. So if same question, if you will be doing by delta star transformation, then same result should come. This is the star kind figure. You will take a common point in between, and now it is looking like a star. This will remove, this will remove, this will disappear, all will disappear, not they will remove, they will disappear, they will create a this figure. One resistance here, one here, one here. And they would be looking like now this. P, one point, and this is Q, this is P, 3, now they are making a star. Suppose this point is M, this point is still M. Now you cannot write R, R, R. They are now different values. Suppose this is R1, this is R2, this is R3, and R1, R2, R3 all are same. Then what will happen? This P point is connected by R1 and R3, 1 and 3 earlier. So this will create R13. Similarly, M point is connected by 1 and 2, R1 and R2, it will create R12, and this will create R23. Value of R12, R13, R23. Here all will be same because all are individual R, R, R. If they are different, then these value will be different. Formula I am writing here. R12 becomes 12, multiply R1, R2 individually, add all three. Denominator in all will be same. R1 into R3 divided by R1 plus R2 plus R3. If you are writing R23, it is R2 into R3 divided by total of 3, R1 plus R2 plus R3. All three resistances, they were creating earlier delta. Now we have made their star. So, little lengthy, na? Yes, it is lengthy. But once you will be understood, then you can find it very easily. You can apply very easily. Now, that's why my favorite is CPM. CPM is my favorite, common potential method, but you should know about the delta star also. So how you will convert delta to star, that I told you. Now I'm finding the value of R13, R2, R23. So this would be, this though we are doing for this, this though is left. okay. So R12, R23, R13 here, it would be, I am solving R12, R1, R2 individually RR, and total of 3 would be 3R, means it is R by 3, it is R by 3. Equivalent resistance we supposed to find out in between P to Q. So you can clearly see current will go like this, and current will go like this only. Current will not flow from this point because this is open point, not connected in any, not making a closed circuit, it is open. So it is open, so it is negligible. Only these two will be assumed, R13 and R23 here. So it is R by 3, they will create how many R by 3, series combination of R by 3, it is R by 3 plus R by 3, 2R by 3. And earlier result also was 2R by 3, it is also 2R by 3. This is delta star transformation. Now let us apply here delta star transformation. So this is the delta I am applying here. Delta star transformation, common point here, 1, 2, 3, these three resistance will disappear. Value of all three is RRR individual. Now they will create like this. So this is also, I'm giving a point, this is suppose D point. So now it would be looking like this. C2, this would be as usual R, this point, and this is as usual also, no change in this R, but this is now, here it was A and this is B, 1, 2, this common point we have taken as D, this was C, this was E, and this is the point, high potential, low potential, point B. So the value all RRR, so quickly I am writing whatever the value of this star after delta, this resistor, these are the values, multiply any two, divided by total of all three, R plus R, 3R, RR gets cancelled, R by 3, it means it is R by 3, it is R by 3, and it is also R by 3, this is the star transformation. Now see, the current will come out from point A, that will go like this, distributes in this and this. So whatever current will come like this, it will pass like this, negative terminal, this is negative, this is positive, and similarly this current will go like this, means this R by 3 and this R, they are in series, this R by 3 and this R, they are in series, and it the circuit now looking like this. Point A, point B, these are connecting where you are free to bend them, you can give any shape. So R by 3 and R in series, so series they will add, 3 1 ja 3 plus 1 4 by 3 R, 4 by 3 R, it is also 4 by 3 R, this was R by 3. Okay, now you can clearly see it is positive, it is negative, so 4 I by R by 3 connected with positive A, and 4 R by 3 is connected with negative, similarly this is also connected here, positive to negative, means there one terminal connected at one common point, second terminal one common point minus B, one is plus A. So this 4R by 3 and this 4R by 3 are in parallel combination. So now it would be looking like, after A these are, so they will be looking like this. This is A, r by 3, and after this point anywhere I can create this point B, and this resistance is parallel of 4r by 3 4r by, similar it would be half 2r by 3. Now this and this in series combination, so final resistance, final equivalent resistance between A and B is just add them 2R by 3 plus R by 3, denominator is same, 3R by 3, 3 gets cancelled, this is also R, by CPM also we were getting R, so it is also correct. CPM, my favorite. This is also one, two time you will apply. I will give you some more more examples, one after another, so many videos, 4-5 videos I will put, different questions, different complicated circuit I will mention there. I will solve all those complicated circuits by using all 2, 3, 4 different methods possible, so that you can easily practice and you can boost your speed to solve those. Okay, and you will be feeling very free to apply these DST, CPM, okay, Wheatstone, balance Wheatstone bridge, and similarity also. Now see, for balance Wheatstone bridge, I am converting this given circuit as this A, I am moving like this, so this would be like this, and this resistance they will come like this. I remove this portion so that you can easily figure out. If I put this wire and I will move like this, the A point will be here, this branch will come here just opposite to it, this also comes here just opposite to it, and it would be looking like this. Similarly, this B also I am taking out like this. This is B, this is A. A positive, B negative. Okay, so this is R, 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 R. This is also R. It is balanced Wheatstone bridge, yes. R by R, R by R. P by Q is equal to R by S. So this branch will not receive any current. These two points would be at common potential. R, these two are in series. These two are in series. If they are in series, they will create 2R. They will also create 2R. Now this 2R and this 2R, they are in parallel combination in between A and B. So final equivalent resistance between A and B, if both two resistance are in parallel connected, they are similar, they are same 2R 2R, then parallel is half of that R. Otherwise you apply the formula 2R into 2R, add them in denominator, 2R plus 2R 4R, R gets cancelled, 2 to 4 only R. So I'm giving you series of different complicated resistance circuits, and I'm going to solve those by DST, by CPM, common potential method, and similarity we will apply, and whatever various possible solution, various possible method would be there, we will try to apply. See you in the next video. You keep practicing. Bye bye.